Listen. So I got about to there. And when I got about there, I began to think of you. And when I got about there in the song and I began to think about my Facebook family and when I began to think about my Periscope family, I said, Father, they need this worship for you. They need to hear that you are so awesome and you're so amazing and that they will love you forever. And then as I began to feel the people of the Lord, I said, okay, God, do I get on scope and do I play this song for them? You know, and I got all these thoughts going through my mind. I said, God, and if I play the song, is it audio only? Because I want you glorified. I don't want the distractions. And, you know, because he was like, what if I don't do it? Will you still love me? Will you still worship me? Will you still praise me when you don't have a reason? When I've done it, if I don't do it, will you still worship me? Will you still honor me? And so I'm like, okay, God. And so I'm like, okay, they need to hear this. And so as I began to go in, I was like, okay, I don't normally come on. How do you want this to happen? And so I began to get ready. And he said, well, what if I don't do it? And let me ask you that question. You know, we go to the what now, God? You said you were going to do it, to what's next. Let me prepare for what's next too. And then his question to you is, what if I don't do it? What if I don't do it? And that's what I want to ask you. And I'm going to hold you right there. I need you to answer it. You know, let yourself answer it. Let your spirit answer it. And then we're going to go further. Because that's when he led me to this word. Because I said, if you don't do it, I'll still bless you. If you never do another thing, I'll still give you glory. If you never make a way, if you never do another thing, I will still give you the glory that you deserve. If you never do another thing, if you never manifest it, Father, if you never do it, because I trust you like that. And so I said, I will love you forever. I'll love you forever. All of my days, through the good and the bad, you are my everything. I will love you forever. And he said, now I know what's in your heart. And so I was like, what? And so because I was like, okay, I'm gonna obey you, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna get ready so that I can do this live, do this Periscope, because I believe God, somebody needs to hear this. And so I said, I will love you forever. If you never do another thing, I'll love you forever, right? And he said, after he said that, he said, now I know what's in your heart. And he led me to this chapter. And so I'm going to go here really quickly. I'm reading out of the Message translation of the Bible. And then I'm going to release the word of the Lord unto you in Jesus' name. And I believe God is going to bless you. Genesis chapter number 22 is where this text is coming from. It's in the Message translation. And it says, after all this, this is verse number 1. God tested Abraham. And God said, Abraham, after all this, and many of you, you've had an after all this in your life, after all that you've gone through, after all of your waiting on the Lord, after all of the tears, after all the stuff you've been through, you know, after Abraham, God has told him to get away from your family, your land, you know, get away from your native people, your culture has shifted. After you had Lot, got rid of Lot, after you went to Egypt and got rid of Egypt, listen, after God made you the promise, after the covenant, after God allowed, you know, you done went and made your own Ishmael, you know, had your own stuff come up. After all this, after God comes and he finally says, by this time next year, you're going to give forth your child. After all this, right? After all this, it happens. Just like he said, after all this happened, it said, God tested Abraham and God said, Abraham, and yes, answered Abraham. He said, I'm listening. And he said, take your dear son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains that I'll point out to you. What you mean? After all this, like after I finally got what you said you were going to do for me, then you want me to go sacrifice it? Okay. So Abraham, it says in verse number 3, got up early in the morning and saddled his donkey. He didn't wait. He didn't delay. He got up early the next morning. God is looking for us to be obedient. And it said he took two of his young servants and his son Isaac. He had split wood for the burnt offering, which means that he was prepared. And so then he set out for the place God had directed him. And on the third day, he looked up and saw the place in the distance. And Abraham told his two young servants, servants, stay here with the donkey. The boy and I are going over there to worship. Then we'll come back to you. And so, you know, he's already speaking by faith. His instruction was go and take him and sacrifice him as a burnt offering. But he speaks and he declares by faith that me and the lad are going up yonder to worship. Now, what's interesting to me is right here, you know, before when God had told Abraham that he was going to give him his own seed and he was going to make of him a many nations, he was like, okay, God, how you going to do it? Because I don't have a kid. And he was like, you're going to do it out of one of the servants, you know, because technically they mine, because whatever I have, it belongs to me. And so they're like, okay, cool. And he's like, no, it's going to be your own seed. So hold up, God, like, I done finally got the promise. I done finally had my son. He ain't got no kids yet. And you want me to sacrifice him? And Abraham, it doesn't say he said anything. Thank you so much for the super heart, Lady Thomasina. May the blessings of the Lord overtake you, woman of God, in Jesus' name. It said that he says to them, the boy and I are going over there to worship. Then we'll come back to you. Will you still worship him? Will you still offer him worship? Will you still offer him whatever you have, even when that comes into question or it feels like it's being tested? And so Abraham took the wood for the burnt offering. And thank you so much for the super heart, Lady Audra. May the blessings of the Lord overtake you, woman of God, in Jesus' name. And he said he gave it to Isaac, his son, to carry. And he carried the flint and the knife, and the two of them went off together. And Isaac said to Abraham, his father, he said, Father? And he said, yes, my son. And then he says, we have flint and wood, but where's the sheep for the burnt offering? And some of you feel like, you know, you done went out there, you done put yourself out there on the limb, you done said, you done believe God, and you're trying to be obedient, you're trying to do everything that he told you to do, right? And people are asking questions because they're not adding up. Things don't make sense, right? And so I'm talking about what if. What if he never do it? What if he questions the very thing that he said he was going to do for you? What if he asks you something that does not make sense? What if? Will you obey him? And so listen, he tells them, Abraham says, son, God will see to it that there's a sheep for the burnt offering. He still remains in faith. He still continues to profess by faith. Will you continue to remain in faith when God not only has taken longer than you thought he should take, or you know what I mean, or he's asking you and he's testing you in areas where you finally feel like, you finally told me you was gonna do this and you testing me, like right now I'm a little bit in my feelings. But it doesn't say Abraham was emotional at all, and so he answers the questions that his son has. Thank you so much for the super art, Miss Pitts. May the blessing of the Lord overtake you, woman of God, in Jesus' name. And it said that he told him that God is going to see to it. God will provide for him own self a sheep for the burnt offering. And they kept on walking. I need to encourage you right now to keep on walking. I know it hasn't come through yet, but just keep on walking. And it says that they kept walking together. They arrived at the place to which God had directed them. And Abraham built an altar and he laid out the wood. Then he tied up Isaac and he laid him on the wood. And Abraham reached out and took the knife to kill his son. He took the knife to literally kill his son. God bless you, Lady Jackie. God bless you, Brother Knox. And so listen, it said, just then the angel of God called out to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, yes, I'm listening. And some of us heard the first instruction and we're moving forward in the first instruction, but we failed to keep listening, and God is still speaking. Listen, you cannot afford in this season to feel like, okay, I heard God, I'm in my feelings, I'm gonna do what I do, and shut your ears off. And so listen, hallelujah. And literally that's what I was doing this morning in prayer. Like, it's not enough to pray and stop. I need you to pray and keep listening. I need you to seek God and still keep listening. Still keep your ears and your eyes open. And so listen, he said, yes, I'm listening. And he tells him, don't lay a hand on that boy. Don't lay a hand on that promise that I gave you. Don't lay a hand on it. I know what I said, but don't lay a hand on that boy. He said, don't touch him. Now I know how fearlessly you fear God. You didn't hesitate to place your son. You didn't hesitate to place your promise, your dear promise, on the altar for me. And you didn't hesitate. You didn't hesitate at all. It said Abram looked up and he saw a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. Abraham took the ram and sacrificed it as a burnt offering instead of his son. He sacrificed that instead of his son. And it said Abraham named that place God Jireh, or Jehovah Jireh, which we say God is my provider. In this translation, it says God sees to it. Let me release this over you today, that God is going to see to it that he does everything that he said that he was going to do for you, through you, and in in your life in Jesus' name, God is going to see to it. And it says, hallelujah, that's where we got the saying, on the mountain of God, God sees it. Listen, not in the valley, on the mountain where the sacrifices take place, where you build the altars of the Lord for the, and what was altars represent? It represented worship. It represented sacrifice on the mountain where you sacrifice, where you give it all, your all in all, where you die to the flesh, where you release everything to him. On the mountain, that's where you see God, Jehovah Jireh, or God as we see it, as God who sees to it, who sees to that thing, that whatever you need, whatever you asking for, whatever you believe in for, whatever is necessary to cause this promise to come to fruition in its fulfillment. Because it wasn't just that Abraham was able to birth an Isaac, but Abraham was promised many nations. And so it could not just stop with just Isaac alone. And just getting the beginning of the promise was not enough alone. Thank God for the Isaac. But Isaac still got to have kids. And Isaac's kids got to still have kids, because this promise that God has for you is bigger than just you. And it's more than one step to it. And so because he had the faith to not quit and was willing to sacrifice on the mountain of our God, right? He was able to see the breakthrough. And it said, hallelujah, this is on the mountain of God, God sees to it. On the mountain, your place of sacrifice, your place of surrender, your altar, that's where you will see the God that sees to it. And it said that, and then the angel of God spoke from heaven a second time, I swear, God's sure word. He said, I swear, God's sure word, because you have gone through this, because you've gone through with this and have not refused to give me your son, your dear son, I'll bless you. In other words, God said, I swear I bless you. I swear to it, I'll bless you. When he could swear by none greater, he swore by himself. And the Lord your God, this morning, this afternoon, wherever you are, whatever time zone you're in, he said, I swear to it that I'm gonna bless you. And he said, hallelujah, I bless you. Oh, how I bless you. And I'll make sure your children flourish like the stars in the sky, like the sand on the beaches, and the descendants that will defeat their enemies. All the nations on the earth will find themselves blessed through your descendants because you obeyed me. God is looking for a people who will obey me. And I know we lost some people along the way, even this morning, even on this live, because they weren't willing to stick through it. And God is saying, if you're willing to stick through it, you're going to see to it because I'm going to see to it. You're going to see it because I'm going to see to it, saith the Lord. In the King James Version, listen, I want to read this because that's how God speaks to me, because that's how much I read the word in King James for so many years. And that's why when he said, what if I don't do it? And I said, God, I'll still worship you. God, I'll love you forever. And I'm in tears and I'm in worship, right? And he says, now I know. Listen, I'm going to read this over here in the King James Version because that's how I heard the Lord begin to speak to me. And he said, unto Abraham when he called out to him the second time, by myself I have sworn, saith the Lord, because you've done this thing and haven't withheld your son, I am blessing, I will bless thee, hallelujah, I will multiply you. And I began to worship the Lord, I began to bless him, even as I began to hear him begin to speak and say what he said, hallelujah. He said in verse number 12 in Genesis chapter number 22 KJV, it said, and he said, lay not your hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him, for now I know that you fear God. Now I know that you fear God because you have not withheld that which I promised to you. And it was, I just couldn't believe it. It was like, God, what you mean? Now you know. Now you know that you can trust me. Now you know that you can trust him. You couldn't trust Abraham when he left his family, when he left his kindred. You couldn't trust Abraham when he left Ur and went to Canaan. You couldn't trust him despite the things you went through. You couldn't trust him when he left Lot. You couldn't trust him through all this. You've seen him obey you. You couldn't trust him in chapter number 21 when he just gave a tithe or a tenth to Melchizedek. You couldn't trust him there. He said, no, but I can trust you now. Now I know. Hallelujah. Now that I know, now that you're willing, that if I say, what if I don't do it, and you're willing to tell me you love me, you're going to love me forever no matter what. Now I know that I can trust you. Now I know certainly. And then he reveals the blessing and he exposes it the more. And that's what God wanted me to say unto you today. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, in my conclusion. conclusion. He said, now that I know that what's in your heart. And God is saying unto many of you who are on here today, 106 of you on Periscope, please share and invite, and those of you on Facebook Live, he said, now I know, hallelujah, what is in your heart. And he said, hallelujah, now, even though the promise, you feel like it was contested, he said, but now that I know what's in your heart. And that's why I had to play that song, to see if you was going to stay on it when it didn't make sense, or are you still going to follow the flow? When the flow seems like it's broken, will you continue to trust in him? Will you continue to believe in him? Now I know what's in your heart, because you didn't just stop. You didn't just give up. You didn't just quit when it didn't make sense. You didn't just keep on or stop when it was no longer convenient. Now I know that you love me, and it's more than just what my hands can do to you and bring for you. Now I know what's in your heart, that you will obey me despite whatever happens. Hallelujah. And it said, and then he began to talk about, you know, we're not jumping into conclusions. We're not done it, doing any of that. Hallelujah. But he said, now that I know what's in your heart. Then he gave me a revelation. See, because before this happened, I had lost my retainer, right? And so let me just be real and honest. This is what the part where the revelation comes in. I had lost my retainer. And so I was looking throughout the house. I was like, where did I lose it at? It must have failed. I don't know if it's in the car. I don't know if I dropped it on the street walking. I don't know if it's somewhere. So I'm looking through trying to find the retainer, and I couldn't find it. And so, you know, through the midst of praying, through the midst of my worship and everything, when I went to go and start putting on my makeup, that's when I had said, you know, let me start over. Before I went to do my makeup, before when I started doing the worship, and I was just like, you know what? I'm done looking for the retainer. I'm not going to look for it anymore. And I told the Lord, I said, Father, I just pray right now in the name of Jesus that you would put it before me. Let me be able to see it, whether it's been there all along and you open up my eyes so that I can see it, or whether you place it there supernaturally, because you know I lost this thing and you just supernaturally have it there. Just let me find it, right? Let me see it. And so either one or two ways, however you do it, I'm good, right? And so just, you know, either let it show up, let me see it, or cause it to come and place it there for me, because God has a way of supernaturally causing things to be there just when you need it. Just like with the ram, just like when the sheep, as Abraham was going up one side of the mountain, because he didn't see that sheep, it must have been that God had the other thing coming up on the other side. Or did God just supernaturally place it there and it didn't even have to walk, it didn't even have to go? And so I'm looking for this retainer, I can't find it, but I go through and I continue, I move forward in worship anyway. And so as I move forward in worship, and then I get the instruction to get on here to live, so I'm trying to put on some makeup to get ready. And soon as I go to do my makeup, I look down on the rug, and what's on the rug? It's the retainer that I have been looking for. He said, I told you, I swore I would bless you. And he said, release this revelation to my people, because, you know, and I was thinking, I was like, okay, God, you know, was it there all the time and I just missed it when I was looking for it, or did you cause it to be there? He said, tell my people, it doesn't matter whether or not they felt like they missed it or they didn't see it. It doesn't matter if I called. What matters is it's there. What matters is it showed up. Hallelujah. And that's what he told me to speak unto you this morning and this afternoon, whatever time's on your end. Hallelujah, to God be the glory, that whether or not it's always been there, or whether it not or not it just appeared, the fact of the matter is, what you've been looking for, what you've been waiting for, what you've been believing for is going to show up, just like he said that it was going to show up. He's going to do it just like he said it was going to do it. And it was right there, and it was right there on time. And it wasn't until I obeyed him, not that I was being disobedient, but I followed another instruction, and he said, now I know what's in your heart. So just as I allowed you to be able to see that which you've been looking for, and many of you have been believing God, looking for the promise, he said, just as you've been waiting on that, just as you've been believing me for that, so too also, hallelujah, the thing that you've been believing me for, the promise that you've been believing me for, it's right there. It's going to show up, hallelujah, just in the time that you need it, in Jesus' name, hallelujah. Just as you've been believing me, it's going to show up, just like I said it was, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just like the ram, it was right there. It's right, God, because God is a God who sees to it, in Jesus' mighty name. And so he told me, he said, release this word over my people, because the promise still stands, in Jesus' mighty name. Now that he knows what's in your heart, the promise still stands. And then he led me over here to Hebrews chapter number 6. I'm going to read this real quickly. In Hebrews chapter number 6, hallelujah, to God be the glory. And And it says in Hebrews chapter number 6, verse number 10, because this is what the word of the Lord is saying unto you all this morning. This is in the Message translation of the Bible. Hebrews chapter number 6, we're going to read starting at verse number 10. And the word of the Lord says, hallelujah, that I am not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love. Hallelujah. He knows perfectly well all the love you've shown him by helping the needy people, and that you keep at it. You kept on doing what I asked you to do. And now I want each of you to extend that same intensity towards a full-bodied hope and keep it all, keep at it till the finish. God is saying, I want you to keep up having that hope till the finish. Don't drag your feet. Be like those who stay the course with committed faith. Hallelujah. I want you to be like those who stay the course with committed faith, and then they get everything that they well, that was promised to them. And God is saying, you're going to get everything that I promised to you in Jesus' name. And when God made his promise to Abraham, this is the exact word that we're talking about. When God made his word to promise to Abraham, he backed it to the hilt, putting his own reputation on the line. And he said he put his own reputation to the line in Jesus' name. I'm going to switch this to the KJV because I'm going to let it bless you the way it blessed me. And he told him, hallelujah, when God could swear by none greater, hallelujah, and when he made a promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swore by himself, saying, surely blessing I will bless thee, and multiplying I will multiply thee. And so after he had patiently endured, he had obtained the promise, and so too shall you obtain the promise in Jesus' name. For men verily swear by the greater, and an oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife, wherein God willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of the promise the immutability of his counsel, the unfailingness of its counsel. He confirmed it by an oath, that by two immutable things in which it was impossible for God to lie, and it's impossible for God to lie to you in Jesus' mighty name, that you can have this strong consolation, saith the word of the Lord, hallelujah, that he is going to do everything that he has said he was going to do. He said, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, and which entereth into that which is within the veil, hallelujah, that I'm going to do everything that I said. I swear I'm going to bless you. I swear I'm going to fulfill my promise to you. I swear I'm going to fulfill my good towards you in the name of Jesus. What if, hallelujah, but now that I know what's in your heart, I swear I'm going to bless you, saith the Lord God, Jehovah Almighty, in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. He's going to do it. 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 Some of you will discover it's like, oh my God, it's been there all the time. I didn't even realize it. I didn't even see it, but your blessing was already there. Some of you are going to be like, oh my God, it seemed like it came out of nowhere, but it's a suddenly that it just appeared, because God says, I am the God, not just your provider, I'm the God that sees to it. I see to it that you have everything you need. I see to it that I fulfill my word. I see to it on the mountain of your sacrifice, on the mountain of your worship, on the altar, hallelujah, that you built for my name, because you glorified me and I know what is in your heart. I shall do everything that I spoke over you and I said I was going to do, saith the Lord this morning in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I love you, beloved. I gotta go. I gotta get out of here. I just wanted to release what the Lord was saying to me. Hallelujah. I couldn't keep that in. I couldn't hold it in my belly. Now I know. I know what's in your heart, saith the Lord. Will you worship me? Because when I do it, when I do it for you, when you get on the other side, listen, there is going to come a time where all the storms are going to cease, where all the battles are over, where they've already been won, where that warfare is over, where you're no longer warring for your promise, and you're on the other side. Will you honor me? Will you glorify me? Will you worship me in spite of? Will you worship me with what I promised you? My God, will you be willing to let it go and trust the God that gave it to you in the first place? Because when I can know what's in your heart, you can absolutely know that I'm going to see to it. I swear I'm going to bless you, saith the God Almighty. I release that upon your people. Father, we give you glory right now. We thank you for who you are and what you've done in the name of Jesus. Father, you are faithful. We come into agreement with your word this morning in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you for all that you've done, all that you're doing, and that what you're going to do. Father, we give you glory right now. We give you glory that you would even download this word unto us in the name of Jesus. Father, and thank you for every confirmation. You are so strategic. I can't even be mad that I couldn't find my retainer, because it was a revelation of your faithfulness and how good you are, how
faithful you are and how you will cause things to happen. And so we get the revelation, we get the understanding. Father, I thank you that you are a God that sees to it. I thank you that you are not a man that you will lie. I thank you that when you could swear by none greater, you swore by yourself, because you couldn't swear that we wouldn't mess up. You couldn't swear that we wouldn't make a mistake. You couldn't swear that Abraham wouldn't go down there and lie. You couldn't swear by none other, but you swore by yourself and for your name's sake, because you are not a man that you should lie. Hallelujah. Neither the son of man that you shall repent. You, what you said you're going to perform, what you said you're going to do in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you that you are not a man, even that you should change your mind. According to 1 Samuel chapter number 15, verse 29, I thank you that you are faithful. I thank you that in you there is no variableness, neither shadow nor turning. You have not changed your mind concerning your people. And I thank you that even as you tested us, even after all this that we've been through, even after all this, we feel like we've been faithful. And through your testing, you tested us some more. But I thank you that you found us faithful. And because we thank you, hallelujah, I thank you that we can find you faithful, that promise, faithful to your word, faithful to your promise, faithful to your provision. Thank you for being a God that sees to it. Thank you that even when people let us down, you will never let us down. Father, I thank you that we can trust you in the twists and in the turns of life. Hallelujah. That even when things get shaky, even when they seem thin, you don't thin out. You are a God that we can count on, we can trust in, we can believe in, we can put our hope, because you are the God that sees to it. And so on this very altar of our heart, we worship you with all that we have, Father. And because we will be able to worship you, Father, even knowing that, like, if you didn't do another thing, that we still love you forever, Father, I thank you, hallelujah, that you know that you can trust us when you do the thing that you said that you were going to do. In Jesus' name, we give you glory, and we thank you now that we can count it done, and it's already done, and it is so. Father, thank you for breakthrough, for resurrection power in the lives of your people, in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you for every open door. Thank you for making every way. Thank you for providing provision. Thank you for vision. Thank you for insight. Thank you for strategy. Thank you for restitution. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for reconciliation. God, thank you for ordering our steps. Thank you for opening up the door, making the way, fulfilling every promise. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's already done. And for that, we give you glory. Absolutely. That's what we said this morning. It is finished. Hallelujah. It's been finished before the foundations of the world. Why? Because he is Alpha and he is Omega. You are the beginning and the end. You're the author and you are the finisher, Father. You are the first and the last. Hallelujah. And there is none like unto thee, Father. I thank you that you wrote the end from the beginning, and Jesus got on the cross and said it was finished, but it had already been finished before he got up there to fulfill that it is finished, right? Because it was done before the foundation of the world, because you already knew, and because you could swear by no greater, and you didn't want us to forfeit what you wanted to do for us. And so you sent your son. Hallelujah. To God be the glory, because you knew that he would not err and he would not fail. Hallelujah. You sent your word. Hallelujah. And you stand and your word even fulfilled what you said that you were going to do in Jesus' mighty name. And the word became flesh and it dwelt among us, and it fulfilled even the assignment in the earth. And so we can stand and say it is finished in the name of Jesus, Father. And we thank you even right now, knowing that the suddenly is already set in stone, is set to happen, and you are causing it to be done. Even now we pray and we say and we thank you and we give you glory in advance. And Father, I thank you for speaking to your people right now by the blood of Jesus, by the power of Almighty God, that your people are ready to shift, that their mindsets are ready to shift to this next season, to this next area of their life, where they are not living in dysfunction, where they are not living in this traumatic society and this traumatic mindset, like they're always feeling like they got this flight or fight mentality, where they live in under this stress and this pressure, because you're getting ready to put them into their promised land, like literally set them in it. And so, Father, when you do that, I thank you, Father, that when we don't have another reason or thought, because you've already done everything that you said you were going to do, you've already done it, and we're sitting in it, Father, that we will yet do what we were created to do, which was to worship you. And so, Father, thank you for birthing the spirit of worship and honor and glory and praise unto your name, because you seek as such to worship you. And so, Father, I thank thank you that you have already set us on a premeditated course for what is to come. Father, thank you for this test run, that we will worship you in spirit and in truth, hallelujah, in spite of and in advance, because you are good and because you are God, not for the thing, but because you are the God. You're the God of everything. And so we worship you because you are God, and because you are good, and because you are almighty, and because we love you, hallelujah, not just the things you do, not just what you said you were going, we love you. We love you forever and ever and ever. You are worthy to be exalted. And so, Father, even as the angels cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. You are the I am, not the I will be, not the I was. And so, Father, I thank you for your nowness and your newness. And I thank you right now that you're going to do what you said you were going to do. And so in our today and in our tomorrow, we're already ready to give you all the glory that's always been yours, because you're faithful and because you're good. In Jesus' name we pray and we say thank you, Father. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Thank you all so much for coming in right now. Whew, I just felt the shift of the Lord. I just pray that y'all have an incredible day and you worship the Lord for what he's going to do. Some of you might need to replay this. God bless you, Mama Moses, and those of you who came in later. Please do me a favor and share an invite. If I missed your super heart, may the blessings of the Lord overtake you in Jesus' name. She said, I'm at work. My Lord, hallelujah. Have a wonderful day. Hallelujah. Give him the worship and praise that is due his name. Set you an altar, build you an altar on your job, build you an altar at your home, wherever you are, put an altar up in your car, make an altar of sacrifice and of worship and adoration unto your God. Give him an offering of your worship. Listen, we're going to have to come to this point where it's not feeling like it's a sacrifice when it's out of the abundance of what he said he was going to do. Listen, will you worship him when it's not a sacrifice of praise? Listen, so I need you to just give him some glory because he's good, because he's God, just because. I don't even need a reason, just because. Hallelujah, what's in your heart? And so I love you. I'm going to go ahead and finish this song as we head out. And be blessed today. God bless you in Jesus' name. I love you.